let us talk now about astronomical telescope. Astronomical telescope. And I am talking here refracting type. Refracting type means where reflection is being involved. Refracting type. Like microscope, telescopes are also consist of two lenses. One is eyepiece lens, another is objective lens. Here objective lens is of large focal length and large aperture. While eyepiece lens is a small focal length and a small aperture. So there is a difference in comparison to the microscope. In case of the microscope, objective is of large focal length, objective is small focal length and small aperture. Eyepiece is of moderate focal length and large aperture, but here eyepiece is of small focal length and small aperture. Objective, in this case telescopes, are used to observe far off objects. There are two ways to use astronomical telescope. Number one is normal adjustment. In this way, we obtain final image of an object at infinity. I mean to say almost at the same distance, or at the same distance wherever object is located. So how to draw ray diagram? Draw one lens as large aperture and large focal length lens. Draw principal axis, straight, a longer line passing through optical center. Take a large focal length of this. Ray coming parallel to the principal axis goes here. Another parallel rays meet here. Another parallel rays I take again joins here. So you obtain image at A dash, B dash, and this is focus of objective lens. In order to obtain image at infinite, it is essential that object must be kept at the focus of a lens. So draw eyepiece lens very close to this image, and eyepiece lens focal length is also coinciding with FO. This is optical center, so same distance, other side you mark focal length of eyepiece lens. Follow the rules. Ray of light coming parallel passes through the focus. The ray of light passing through optical center moves straight. If when you follow the rule and by measuring distances, these distances are same, this is equal to this, then automatically you will obtain a parallel rays finally coming out, emerging out. So you can work it out very well and in the ray diagram. Object is at infinity and final image is also formed at infinity. Magnifying power of this normal and in normal adjustment is defined as same definition except the last sentence changes. Ratio of angle subtended by an image to the angle subtended by an object when image and object both lie at least distance of distinct vision. So you can see this angle I assume made by an object. So this is alpha, this is leading to an image beta. So from right angle triangle, A dash, B dash, O, you can get tan alpha is equal to A dash B dash over B dash O. From right angle triangle, A dash B dash OE, you can calculate tan beta. Where is A dash B dash OE? This, this and this is equal to A dash B dash B dash OE. Substituting these values of equation in equation number 1, therefore M becomes equal to B dash O over B dash OE, that is FO over minus FE. This is a magnifying power of telescope in normal adjustment. Total length of the tube that will be equal to mod of FO plus mod of FE. That's how you can calculate. There are some small numerical problems are asked. Say for example, if I say the magnifying power of astronomical telescope in normal adjustment, magnifying power of telescope in normal adjustment is 20. If the length of the tube forty-two centimeter, calculate focal length of objective and eyepiece. So use formula M is equal to FO over FE, that gives you the value 20 is equal to FO over FE. This means FO is equal to 20 FE, and then using relation L is equal to FO plus FE, that is 42 is equal to 20 FE plus FE. So FE is equal to 2 centimeter and FO is equal to 40 centimeter. That's how you can calculate your answer. Telescope second mode of operation. When final image is formed at least distance of distinct vision. There is a slight change in drawing diagram for this and earlier normal adjustment. Again, you make a large convex lens. This will be your objective lens. Draw a straight line passing through optical center. And then take parallel rays of light. One is passing through optical center, other two rays are passing from sideways. Extend this, and these you can join. This here you have got image A, B, and this image will be at the focus of objective lens. Now keep your eyepiece lens very close to this. It's smaller in focal length. Mark focal length little this side. The same focal length you can mark this side. I mean to say the image formed by objective lens must lie in between focus and optical center of eyepiece lens. Follow the rules. Ray of light coming parallel passes through focus. The ray of light passing through optical center moves straight, extend in the back. Draw perpendicular from principal axis. This will be your final image, A dash, B dash. This is an angle alpha. This is also alpha. Samely, this is beta. But now this is UE, distance of object from eyepiece lens. And final image is formed at least distance of distinct vision. Let's derive formula for magnifying power for this. As far as definition of magnifying power is concerned, same. It is the ratio of angle subtended by an image to the angle subtended by an object. When image lies at least distance of distinct vision, an object lies at infinity. So this is equal to beta over alpha. So similarly, for a small angle you can write 10 beta over 10 alpha. Choose an appropriate triangle from the figure. From figure, triangle ABO. ABO, you can get 10 alpha. That is AB over BO, equation 3. And from triangle ABOE, you can get 10 beta. That is AB over BOE. Till here equation looks similar, as we have done a normal adjustment. Substituting in equation number 2, then M is equal to BO over BOE. BO is FO, but BOE is not FE now, it is minus UE. Is that clear? Using lens formula for eyepiece, formula for eyepiece lens. When you use lens formula, what you will have? 1 over FE is equal to 1 over V minus 1 over UE. U is negative, V is negative. So you will have 1 over FE is equal to minus 1 over D plus 1 over UE. From here you get the value of 1 over UE. 1 over FE plus 1 over D. Put this value here in equation number 5. Substitute this value in equation number 5. When you put the value in equation number 5, what you will have? Magnifying power M is equal to F minus F into 1 over UE. That is minus F naught, and this is FE into D, FE plus D, minus FO over FE. In the bracket you will have 1 over FE over D. This is formula for magnifying power of telescope at least distance of distinct vision. You can use this formula. Let's see now reflecting type of telescope. A reflecting type of telescope . These types of the telescope consist of parabolic mirrors rather than using lens, because reflection takes place from the mirror. So in reflecting type of telescopes, we have one large parabolic concave mirror having hole at the center, and like this, this is large parabolic mirror. Here we will fix up your eyepiece lens to see the image in the same line. Wherever it's focus, say focus is here, in between focus and this, we place another convex mirror. So the rays of light coming parallel to the principal axis finally reflects, approaches to focus, and these rays reflect back to the eyepiece lens where we obtain image. I repeat again, M1 is large parabolic concave mirror, M2 is a small mirror, convex in nature, the rays of light coming parallel to the principal axis gets reflected, falls on convex mirror, reflects back towards the pole, and right at the pole of parabolic mirror M1, we have a hole where we have fixed up eyepiece lens, and we obtain image in eyepiece lens. Magnifying power of reflecting type telescope is given by FO over FE. You can calculate. FO is the focal length of large parabolic mirror. We can mark this FO, and FE is the focal length of mirror M2. We have seen two types of telescopes, reflecting type of telescope and one reflecting type of telescope I have shown. Now, what is difference? Which one is better? So we have a next heading, advantages of reflecting type telescopes over refracting type of telescopes. Reflecting type of telescopes have so many advantages. Image formed is brighter than the refracting type of telescope. It is easier to make a large focal length and large aperture of mirror than the lens. I mean to say, it is easier practically to make a mirror of larger focal length and larger aperture in comparison to the lens. It has large magnifying power of reflecting type telescope is much higher than the refracting type of telescope. It has large resolving power of reflecting type of telescope is also better than the spherical than the refracting type of telescopes. And the most important thing is that these are free from spherical and chromatic aberration. What is spherical aberration? Spherical aberration, you know, there is a curvature in the lens. So when rays fall on a mirror, here is the curvature, this is rays of the light fall on this lens. When the rays falls, paraxial rays coincide and finally meet exactly at the focus. However, the rays which are moving from outer curved surfaces, they don't focus or meet exactly on the focus of the lens. They move little ahead and not forming a point object, but slightly linear image. I repeat, the rays coming parallel, paraxial rays in this central portion, they exactly coincide to the focus of the lens. The rays which are passing through the curved surface, spherically curved surface, they don't focus exactly at the same point, but they focus at certain distance apart. And forms an image. So there are two types of the spherical aberration. One is longitudinal, this is longitudinal, and the image is not point object, this is called transverse spherical aberration. There is another aberration called chromatic aberration. In chromatic aberration, as we know, when light radiation, white light passes through the lens, it observes different color, observes different refractive indices, different refractive index of the same material. So all the colors do not coincide at the same point focus, but the color according to their wavelength deviates, and deviation varies means you will have a colored and blurred image that you can do even in your class. Normally in the laboratories at your level, the lenses are chromatic. These are not achromatic lenses. So when you bring object closer to a focus, you will find the image of the object is getting colored and blurred. That is chromatic aberration. And chromatic aberration arises because of dispersion of light. Let's talk about one term we have used here, resolving power. What is resolving power? It is an ability of an optical instrument to separate or resolve the images of two nearby objects which cannot be seen as separate by naked eyes. I repeat again, resolving power is an ability of an optical instrument to separate or resolve the images of two nearby objects which cannot be seen as separate by naked eyes. What exactly resolving power I mean to say? Let's have an example before going to discuss further. Suppose these are two nearby objects A and B. Probably you cannot mark right now. There is a one instrument T1 where I observe these two objects by this. We saw the images of two objects like jacket B. This instrument or optical instrument shows images of these two objects A and object B like this. When same object is seen by another optical instrument T2, the images are formed like this. Do you notice the difference in these two images? First optical instrument T1 has very good resolving power because it is able to separate out the two nearby objects at largest possible distance. Second instrument T2, it has very good magnifying power because it has enlarged the image. However, the separation distance between two images is lesser than the T1. So we can easily say T1 has more resolving power and less magnifying power. However, T2 has less resolving power and more magnifying power. Now question arises, can we increase magnifying power and resolving power both to a larger extent? Answer is probably up to a certain limit. Suppose I have these two objects A and B, I observe by optical instrument T1. Earlier we obtained images like this. Now I want to increase magnifying power. Increase the magnifying power. It means size of the image is enlarged. Automatically you see the resolving power is decreased. So I mean to say, if you want to have higher resolving power and higher magnifying power, this can be achieved to a certain extent. Beyond that limit, you can increase either of the power at the cost of other. If you increase magnifying power, resolving power of the instrument will suffer. Right? Let's see resolving power of microscope. Resolving power of microscope. It is defined as the reciprocal of the smallest distance between two objects whose images are seen distinctly or separately by microscope. It is defined as the smallest distance between two objects whose images can be seen distinctly by microscope, and this is termed as limit of resolution. For microscope, according to Rayleigh, he has a great contribution in optics. Rayleigh, this is equal to lambda over 2 mu sine theta. And as per this, resolving power is 1 over d. So 2 mu sine theta over lambda. So resolving power is reciprocal of limit of resolution. Now what is where? What is where? See, this is objective of microscope. This is an object kept here. This is a line joining the aperture, optical center. This angle, half of an angle, is theta. Mu is refractive index between lens and object. Whatever medium is there, the refractive index of medium between lens and object. Lambda is wavelength of light which is falling on object at that time. So it is reciprocal to the wavelength. It also depends on refractive index of the medium between object and the lens. Now next is resolving power of telescope. What is definition of resolving power of telescope? It is defined as reciprocal of the smallest angular separation. It is defined as the reciprocal of smallest angular separation between two distant objects whose images are just seen as separate. I repeat, it is defined as reciprocal of smallest angular separation between two distant objects whose images are just seen as separate. And d theta, again calculated by the Rayleigh, and that is equal to 1.22 lambda over d. So resolving power is equal to d over 1.22 lambda. What is this angle d theta? So this is your lens. These are two nearby objects A and B. A subtends this angle, B subtends this angle from the principal axis. This angle is d theta. So resolving power of telescope also depends on aperture capital D of the lens as well as wavelength of light used. There was a question in the board examination this year. It goes like this. Define resolving power of telescope and how does resolving power is affected with increase of wavelength. So by increasing wavelength, when wavelength increases, then RP decreases. Simple. When diameter increases, RP increases. When diameter decreases, resolving power decreases. That's what is the answer. Simple. I repeat it again. On increasing wavelength, resolving power decreases. On decreasing wavelength, resolving power increases because it has reciprocal relationship. Right? When D is increasing, resolving power is increasing. When D is decreasing, resolving power decreases. Now, there are some conceptual questions are asked in the optics very commonly related with this. Why do we prefer in case of telescope an objective lens of large focal length and large aperture? See, if we look at the telescope magnifying formula, it is FO over FE. Larger focal length of the object increases magnifying power. Resolving power formula you have just seen, directly proportional to the diameter, that is aperture. Larger aperture of objective lens of the telescope increases number of view of vision, area of vision as well as resolving power. Why in question number 2, why in microscope objective lens is of a small focal length? And a small focal length and a small aperture. A small aperture we need because we have to focus a tiny object. So we need not require a larger aperture because object is not big. Then why do I need a small focal length? Do you remember the formula of the focal length? If not, then I can remind you again. Magnifying power is minus L over F naught into D over FE. That's why focal length of eyepiece lens is also not taken large, it's moderate. Focal length of objective is taken very small because magnifying power can be increased. So, try this to maximize resolving power as well as magnifying power of the devices.